Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are doing good. Today we are going to discuss chapter number 4, Animal Kingdom, and the topic is Animal Construction and Classification of Animal Kingdom. Now in this video, we will discuss about only animal construction. Now before this, we have done 2 kingdom classification, 3 kingdom, 4 kingdom as well as 5 kingdom classification. However, the 5 kingdom classification which was given by R.H. Whittaker is widely accepted. So this chapter is mostly based on R.H. Whittaker 5 kingdom classification. Now talking about R.H. Whittaker 5 kingdom classification, the 5th kingdom is kingdom Animalia. Now before kingdom Animalia, let's talk about animals. So animals, they are multicellular eukaryotic and heterotrophic organisms that acquire energy by ingesting the organic molecule of other organisms. That means here in this line, 3 important points are there. That means they are multicellular, means they are made up of more than one cell. They are eukaryotic, which shows a true nucleus inside their body, and they are heterotrophic. Since they do not have chlorophyll, they cannot perform the process of photosynthesis, so they are totally dependent on other organisms, and they used to ingest the organic molecules just like the food, and they need to break down the complex food into the simpler form. So these are basically a significant characteristics of animals. Apart from this, there are certain characteristics of multicellular organisms, such as they require more energy in comparison to unicellular organisms. Since unicellular organisms are extremely small, so they don't require a large amount of energy. However, in case of multicellular organisms, every cell needs to perform their individual functions, so they require a lot of energy. Now, they are having a well-developed alimentary canal for ingestion, means the process of taking the food, for digestion, basically the breakdown of food into simpler form, and egestion to expel out that food from the body. Now, they are having a well-developed skeletal system. The role of this skeletal system is to protect the internal organs. Such as, for example, in our body, our skeletal system is protecting our internal organs like lungs, liver, kidneys. All these are the internal organs. Now, next, they are having a well-developed central nervous system, and this is for control and coordination. Now they are having a parallel coordination of endocrine system. That means it is related to the hormones. So all the hormonal activities is also very much necessary for the growth and development of the body. And when we talk about the hormones, hormones are basically are the chemical messenger. So hormones, they be can be further classified into exocrine and endocrine glands. That means some glands which is producing hormones directly in the blood, and some glands which is producing the hormone into some other glands, some other ducts. Now they are having a well-developed transport system. That means they are having a blood vascular system, and by the help of this blood, all the nutrients, all the oxygen or all the gases is transported in the body, as well as the excretory product are expelled out from the body. Now one of the main characteristics is that embryonic development after the larval phase and metamorphosis. Metamorphosis is basically the division of the body cells. So all these are the vital functions, are the vital characteristics of multicellular organisms. Now when we come to the topic animal classification, animals are divided on the basis of various characteristics and parameters. And in this video, we will talk about these parameters. The first parameter is the habitat. As you know that all the living organisms, they require a suitable environment for their survival. And this suitable environment is known as a habitat. A habitat is a type of natural environment in which a particular species of organism lives. Now, these organisms, they are depend on various things such like food, shelter, protection and mate for reproduction. That means they require a suitable amount of food, sufficient amount of food, shelter, protection, as well as a well breeding ground for the continuity of their species. Now they both depend on factors like physical and biological. When we talk about physical factors, so physical factors, it includes light, temperature, concentration of water. And when we talk about biological features, it include the concentration or the amount of flora and fauna present in that area. So all these are the vital requirements for the survival of an organism. Now, when we talk about animals' habitat, they are further classified into aquatic and terrestrial forms. Aquatic, as you know, that those animals which is living inside water. Now, they are further classified into three types, and these are zooplanktons, nectons, and benthic. Whereas, in case of terrestrial animals, they are further classified into five forms, and these are fossorial, cursorial, scansorial, arboreal, and aves. Now, in the next slide, we will discuss about these forms. Aquatic animals. Aquatic animals include both the freshwater and marine animals. Now, they are further classified into three types: zooplanktons, nectons, and benthic. Zooplanktons are extremely small animals which is found on the surface of water. They are found along phytoplanktons, and the characteristics is that they are light in weight so that they can easily be carried away by the water drift. For example, Daphnia. Second is the nectons. Nectons are those animals which is found in the middle of the water, and they used to swim independently in that region. For example, fishes. The third one is the benthic. Benthic are those animals which is found on the ground surface of sea and river. For example, all the invertebrates, they are mostly present in that region, and the common example is starfish. Now, talking about terrestrial habitat, the terrestrial animals, they are further classified into five types. The first one is the fossorial animals, those animals which used to dug holes and live inside tunnels. These are known as fossorial animals. For example, moles and earthworm. Next is the cursorial animals. Those animals which are adapted for a fast running is known as cursorial animals. For example, horse, deer, all these are cursorial animals. Next one is arboreal animals. Arboreal animals are those animals which spend most of their lives living on the trees. For example, squirrel, koalas, and primates like monkeys. Next one is scansorial animals. Scansorial animals, they are modified to climb on trees. They mostly find attached on the rocks or in branches. So these are known as scansorial animals. A well example is lizard. Now the next is aerial animals. Those animals which are adapted for flight or for gliding in the air, these are known as aerial animals. For example, birds, insect, bats. Now, aerial animals, they are arboreal also because they used to build their nest on the trees. Now, the second parameter is body plan, that is levels of organization. Now, animals, they are further classified into three levels, and these are cellular level, tissue level, and organ level. Now, when we talk about cellular level, in this, it is present in the multicellular organism. Now, one very much important thing is there, in this, no coordination takes place between the cells. Means every cell is doing their individual functions, like every cell is doing the process of respiration, exchange of gases, excretion, but they are not coordinating with each other. And the best example of cellular level is sponges. Now, the next one is the tissue level. Now, tissue level is also found in the multicellular organism. Now, here, these tissues, these are formed by the combination of the cell. Now, these cells, they complement each other and they form work in coordination. For example, like nerve cells, which is present in the human for the conduction of message, muscle cells for contraction, as well as the RBC for transporting oxygen, and gland cells for secretion. So all these, they are associated with each other and they are performing a specific task. These are known as tissue level. Now, when we talk about organ level, now it is also present in the multicellular organisms, and in this various tissues, they are coordinating with each other to form an organ, and organ is doing the specific function. Now there is division of labor. That means each organ is doing a specific task in the body. For example, the lungs is associated with the functioning of respiration, like exchange of gases. The kidneys, they are doing the process of removing metabolical waste from the body, as well as the liver. It is doing the both the process, like it is involved in digestion as well as it is involved in the excretory process. So these all includes the level of organization in animals. Now body plan is further classified into three types: cell aggregate body plan, blind sac body plan, and tube within a tube. When you talk about cell aggregate body plan, in this the cells, they are aggregated at one place and they are doing their specific functions, but they are not coordinating with each other. These are similar to cellular level of organization. For example, in sponges, this type of body plan is generally found. Next is blind sac body plan. In blind sac body plan, there is division of labor, means there is division of tissues which are doing their functions, but they are having only one opening to outside, means they are having one opening, and from one opening they are doing the process of digestion as well as excretion. For example, Hydra. Now third one is tube within a tube. Now it includes the organ system level, in which all the organisms, they are doing their individual function. And remember that this type of level is generally found in those animals which is having well-developed alimentary canal. So one of the important thing to remember here is that during the formation of zygote, and from zygote when it is changes into an embryonic stage, this start leading to the formation of marula, and the marula it further divided into various cells which is forming a blastula. A blastula is basically an animal embryo at the early stage of development when it is hollow ball of cells. Now during this time the division of the body take place, and whenever it goes into that gastrulation stage, now it either forms mouth first and anus later, or it can form anus first and mouth later, because due to the invigilation of the cells, if they are forming mouth first and anus later, these are known as prostosomes, and if they are forming anus first and mouth later, these are known as deuterostomes. Now the next parameter is body symmetry. When you talk about symmetry, symmetry is basically a balanced geometrical design divisible into equal parts by lines or planes of division called symmetry. So it is also further classified into four types, and these are asymmetry, bilateral symmetry, spherical symmetry, and radial symmetry. Now when we talk about asymmetrical, that means whenever we are cutting an organism and if it is not divided into equal half from any plane, these are known as asymmetrical body plan. For example, these are generally found in sponges and amoeba. The second one is spherical symmetry. Now those animals which are basically sphere in shape, they are a perfect example of spherical symmetry, because if we cut their body in any plane, they will divide it into equal halves. And for example, volvox and coccus bacteria. Coccus bacteria are basically spherical bacteria. Now the third one is radial symmetry. When we talk about radial symmetry, these radial symmetry are generally found in those organisms in which whose body can be divided into similar halves passing from a plane at any angle along a central axis. For example, starfish. If we cut the starfish, the one of the part is complementary to the other part, so it will form the exact mirror image of the body parts. For example, jellyfish and sea animals are the perfect examples. Now talking about bilateral symmetry. Bilateral symmetry includes those organisms whose body can be divided into two equal halves, and these equal halves are the exact mirror images of each other. For example, the left half and the right half, both are the mirror images of each other. Now the one important thing is that this organism need to be cut from the middle line, and this middle line is known as sagittal plane.
Now these organisms, they are having anterior, posterior, dorsal and ventral side. For example, the fish is the best example of bilateral symmetry. Now here in this, if you see the body structure, they are having the anterior, that is the front part, posterior, that is the back part, dorsal, that is the upper top layer, and ventral is the bottom side. So all these parts are there and they can be mirror images to each other when we cut down from the middle section. Now the next important parameter is body cavity, that is coelom. Some animals have this body cavity while some animals are lacking this body cavity. Coelom is basically a fluid filled cavity present between gut and the outer body wall. Now there is some characteristics of coelom. The first one is all the internal organs, they are embedded in this coelom. So all the internal organs, they are doing the functions in this coelom only. Second is their hydrostatic skeletal system. That means they provide a large amount of flexibility to do function by various organs. Third, they are shock absorber. That means it is protecting all the internal organs by any jerk. Fourth, it separates the body wall and the alimentary canal from each other so that both of them, they can do their functions individually and independently. Next, they provide a large space for enlargement of organs. Since organs, they are made up of tissues, and tissues, they used to grow in size. So they provide a large space for the enlargement of organs. Now they also act as a transport system, means they are taking food, waste materials and gases along with the osmoregulation.
Osmoregulation means the maintenance of constant osmotic pressure in the fluid of organisms by the control of water and salt concentration. So means it is balancing the water and the salt concentration in the body also.
Now on the basis of presence or absence of this coelom, animals are further classified into acoelomate and coelomate. Now acoelomate, these are those organisms in which they are lacking this body cavity, means in which coelom are not present. Now, in such animals, the mesoderm, that is the middle part, it is acquiring the complete space between the ectoderm and endoderm, means the middle part is taking the complete space of outer part as well as the inner part. For example, here in this figure, if you see, it is the structure of porifera, that means it is an example of sponges. So they are generally having this type of body cavity, which is a coelomate.
Now talking about coelomate, the first one is the pseudocoelom.
Pseudocoelom are those animals which is having a false coelom, that means a false body cavity. So these body cavity, these are generally present from the embryonic stage, and in this the various internal organs are present. For example, these are generally found in nematodes and rotifers. Here if you see the structure in this figure, you will find that a digestive tract is separated from the outer body part, and here you find a white colored layer is there, that is known as the pseudocoelom. Now pseudocoelom, they are generally found during the breeding stage, which is basically during the formation of blastula. So it is separating both the ectoderm and the endoderm.
Now next one are those organisms or those animals which is having a true coelom, and they are also known as eucoelomate. Now in those organisms, the mesoderm, it is basically the line by coelom which give rise to various muscles, and these muscles, they are surrounding the gut as well as the underlining body wall or body parts. They are generally found in annelida such as earthworm, arthropoda and mollusca. Here in this figure you can see the digestive tract which is in the endoderm and the outer covering, that is the ectoderm. Now in between that there is a layer of tissue which is made up of coelom, and these internal organs are generally present in this coelomic region.
Now the next one is hemocoelom. Hemocoelom are those organisms in which a true coelom is present, and this coelom, it is filled with blood. The blastocoel, that means the body cavity, it is consist of the sinuses. Sinuses are basically a cavity which is present within a bone or other tissue. Especially these are present in the bones of the face or skull connecting with nasal cavities. Now here in this, the animals, they are having an open circulatory system. Open circulatory system we will discuss later. Now hemocoelom, it work as a blood vessels. Basically it work in the translocation of blood or transportation of blood from one body part to the other. And this type of arrangement is generally found in arthropoda and mollusca. Now the next important topic is body development or germ layers. Germ layer is basically a layer which is formed during the division of cells whenever a zygote is transforming into an embryonic stage. Now this germ layer, it is formed by the process of gastrulation. Now on the basis of germ layer, a body is divided into two groups, and these are diploblastic and diploblastic. Diploblastic means if a body is having two layers, that means ectoderm and endoderm. Ectoderm is the outer layer, endoderm is the inner layer. So they are known as diploblastic animals. They are generally found in lower metazoans and coelenterates. While if an animal is having three germ layers, basically three parts, and these are ectoderm, endoderm, and apart from this, mesoderm, the middle layer is also present. These are known as triploblastic animals. These are generally found in higher metazoans. Now, one of the important characteristics of animals is body segmentation, that is known as metamerism. Now, some of the animals, they are possessing segments in their body. For example, earthworm. Now, if you see the structure of earthworm, the body of earthworm comprises almost 120 to 130 segments in their body, and it can be viewed externally. While in case of humans, we are having internal metamerism. For example, the central nervous system of our body, in which it is divided into various branches due to the formation of septa. Now the next parameter is cephalization. Cephalization is basically the concentration of nervous system towards the anterior end in animals, or simply we can say the process of head formation. Now whenever these nervous system, they get concentrated in the anterior end, they just form a brain. So the animals belonging from flatworm to chordates, all these have a well-developed brain. Now the next parameter is body temperature. On the basis of body temperature, animals are further classified into homeothermal, that is warm-blooded, and poikilothermal, that is cold-blooded. When we talk about homeothermal animals, in these animals, their body temperature does not change whenever there is change in external condition. Means their body temperature remain constant. For example, birds and mammals. While in case of poikilothermal animals, cold-blooded animals, their body temperature changes as soon as the environment getting colder. So they need to do various types of adaptations such as hibernation and estivation. Hibernation, as you know, it is a period of winter sleep, while estivation is a period of summer sleep. So the animals belonging to invertebrates, amphibians and reptiles, all these undergo adaptation for their survival. Now the next parameter is notochord. Notochord is basically the backbone. So a notochord is a primitive beginning of the backbone derived from the mesoderm. In case of humans, it is basically the extension of medulla of the brain through the neural canal up to the lumbar region. It is basically a rod-like structure which is there for providing support to the body. Now on the basis of this notochord, means whether the backbone is present or not, due to which the animals is further divided into two categories, and these are chordates and non-chordates. Chordates includes those animals which is having a backbone. For example, birds, animals, all these comes under chordates.
while those animals which is lacking this notochord, which is lacking this backbone, are known as non-chordates. So invertebrates, amphibians, reptiles, all these comes under non-chordates.
Now the last parameter is circulatory system. Circulatory system, as you know, that it is a network of blood vessels and the heart. Now this network, this has a role of translocation or transportation of oxygen and other nutrients, hormones, as well as it is excretory role, that it is removing the waste product from the body. Now on the basis of circulatory system, the animals, they are having two types of circulatory system, open type and closed type. When you talk about open type circulatory system, in this the blood pumped out of the heart to the cells and tissues, but they are lacking capillaries. In this animals, capillaries are not present. In fact, the blood, it goes directly into the sinuses. It means it goes directly into the body cavity. And the common example of open type circulatory system is arthropoda and mollusca. While in case of closed type circulatory system, the blood, it flows through a series of vessels like arteries, veins and capillaries. Arteries, as you know, that it is carrying the blood from heart to different part of the body. Veins, it carry the blood from different part of the body back to the heart. And capillaries, it is a basically the junction of arteries and veins where the blood get oxygenated and deoxygenated. So this type of circulatory system, that means closed type circulatory system, is found in annelida and all vertebrates.
So students, here in this video we have discussed about various parameters, and on the basis of these parameters the animals are classified into various phylums. In the next video, we will talk about various phylums of animals. Apart from this, if you are having any doubt or any query, you can clear your doubt in Zoom session, or you can ask directly in WhatsApp. Thank you.